the Word of God. The truth which makes men free from the bondage of self to serve others. It delivers the kingdom
of God. Mountains, majesty, top of the fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee.
Upon you and give you peace, both now and forevermore, world without end. Amen.
Hey, we're going. No man's land.
Hey, Jack.
Wind it up for them. Come on.
Refocus again.
Not the bottom.
I'll ruin your camera yet. There it is. Here we go.
August 1976, two American officers were murdered there in the retreat in detail of attack by North Korean guards. In response, the United Nations command closed that bridge to all North Korean traffic. The North Koreans then built the 72-hour bridge, which is their sole access into Panmunjom. Look beyond those two green buildings straight up, you'll see a white building. That is the so-called Peace Museum in 1953, the Armistice was signed. Just beyond that white building, you can see two smokestacks. And that's the Czech Pole Village. Two delegations of the Neutral Nations Supervisory Commission are housed there. Our two delegations are housed in the Swiss Sweet Village, which is right where that white radar
building.
Just to the right of that, you can just barely see a North Korean guard tower. That's a North Korean guard tower. Last point of interest, the American guard was
yes, sir.
Would you like to see if you can see the statue there?
Thank you.
Yeah, well, I knew that, but I know it's steroids, so I didn't know. Reinforced that quite a bit.
You want to see that statue, sir? It looks like it's straight off, you know, to the right. It's nestled in the hills, in the valley. Out in the forest, far hills. You can just be able to see that one.
Cable between two people. Cable between us.
There you go. He's right.
What did you see, Mr. President?
What?
What did you see?
I'm looking for the statue out there, the 75-foot statue of Kim Il-sung.
What are your thoughts, sir?
Well, right now, I'm filled with pride. All that I've seen and for these men here. And struck with how little the citizens there protecting our own people in America know about this and what they're doing. I'm going to try to change that.
What about that over there?
What?
What about that over there?
You mean the imitation village?
It's a fake village.
Yes. Looks like a Hollywood back lot. Isn't any more important.
Okay, leaving right now. Hey, this is going to Libertyville, right?
All over here. No, well, okay, see that dike that goes after it opens up where there is no more dike. 100 meters after that is the north.
It's curving in and goes out like that. It's not straight across.
I wonder what they're going to be like when they get wet, though.
Just move a bit.
I'm going to take that camp dry.
You kidding?
The man's coming.
Pleasure for me to welcome the President of the United States to the 2nd Infantry Division, the most forward deployed. Thank you very much, General.
It's an honor for me to be with you. And as you see this morning, the first thing when I got here, somebody made sure that I would be dressed in what the well-dressed man American is wearing. And I'm very proud to have that. Somebody asked me if I'd be safe up here so close to North Korean troops. I said, son, look, if you were in charge of a brand new country, you finally got a division created, what would you call it? He said, well, I guess I'd call it the 1st Division. He said, well, instead, I will always remember. There's no better proof of the relationship between strength and freedom than we love you, 2nd Infantry Division. You stand between the free world and the armed forces of a system that is hostile to everything we believe in as Americans. The communist system to the north is based on hatred and oppression. It brutally attacks every form of human liberty, health, energy, and creativity abound. The positive mood of the people, their enthusiasm and work, are profound repression and military might. The only thing deterring the use of that military might is a commitment by the Korean people here in the South and the dedication of brave men and women like yourselves. You and the 2nd Infantry, we fully understand the hardship of your task. We know about the cold, windswept nights that leave you aching from head to foot, I'm sure. We know about it, and we know about the danger. You're facing a heavily armed, unpredictable enemy with no record for or regard as the sacred human life. Let's always remember August 18th, 1976, the day that two Army officers, Major Arthur Bonaparte, I understand the final count now is the final identification is 239. Our Marines and soldiers gave the last full measure of devotion in that honorable endeavor, and each of us is indebted to every one of them. Recently, as you know, we sent our forces to the island of Grenada. Some critics compared that operation to the Soviet invasion of Afghanistan in Grenada. Let me ask a question of my own. Why are the Soviets being attacked? The soldiers who have deserted in Afghanistan. And a significant thing is, in different areas, without them having a chance to communicate with each other or even knowing about each other, one of the prime reasons they have given us, young Russians, men like yourselves, only from Russia, for deserting, is they were ordered to kill women and children. And some of them prove that there is still some hope there among the people, if the people can ever get a citizen living there. And anyone who questions whether the lives were in jeopardy should read the letters I received from those students. And on television, we saw them dropping down when they stepped off the planes in Carolina, kissing the ground as they arrived in America, saw it the American people are. We call what we did in Grenada an invasion, as many have, that will make the difference between slavery and freedom, and more importantly, between peace and war. Master Sergeant Ernest Coombe, who exposed himself to enemy fire by manning his machine gun recipients. Yet we know that all who fought here were heroes and deserve our respects. They did their duty, tradition, and those who went before you. And I know that you're keeping faith with them, 2nd Infantry Division. God bless you, and God bless America. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. Warrior!
What?
It's put!
It's put, 2nd Infantry!
outside!